And we have this, Justin. The unemployment rate in the Philippines drops to 5.2% in July from 6%. 5.2% translates to 2.6 million jobless Filipinos. That's an improvement from June's 2.99 million unemployed. The country's employment rate also inching higher to 65.2% from 64.8% in June. Quarter on quarter, sectors that added the most jobs are wholesale and retail trade, agriculture and forestry, and accommodation, as well as food services. Meanwhile, industries that lost the most jobs are manufacturing, education, human health, and social work activities. The Manila Economic and Cultural Office clarifies Filipinos can still enter Taiwan without a visa. This even after Taiwan's Bureau of Consular Affairs said it will temporarily suspend visa-free entries for Filipinos as well as citizens from 11 other countries beginning September 12. No reason was cited for the move, but MECO Chairman Silvestre Bello III calls the announcement fake news. Filipino travelers have been enjoying visa-free entry to Taiwan since November 2017.
It's not true. Ang impact natin ang ambassador sa akin. Please ask them to stop spreading the false news. Nagkaroon nga ng misunderstanding according to him because of the statement na they were giving US, Germany, and other countries, not mentioning Philippines. So nagkaroon ng conclusion na hindi tayo kasama doon sa privilege of visa-free entry. Opo, we are still enjoying yung visa-free entry to Taiwan tayo mga Pilipino.
Passengers of a Philippine Airline flight going to Hong Kong last September 5 are asked to monitor their health. That's after one of the passengers on board was reported to have been infected with monkeypox. The patient is considered Hong Kong's first imported case of the disease. He is a 30-year-old man who also recently traveled to the U.S. and Canada. His nationality has yet to be identified, according to the Philippine Health Department. PAL, meanwhile, says those who were in close proximity with the infected passenger have already been notified, while health officials from the Philippines and Hong Kong are already coordinating to share relevant information. The Philippines has so far reported 4 cases of monkeypox. Now, here are some economic events for monitoring today, Thursday. We're actually on central bank watch today with Malaysia set to announce its latest policy decision. It's poised to deliver a third consecutive 25 basis point interest rate hike to quell growing inflationary pressures. But economists polled by Reuters also think the central bank will opt to move slowly despite a hawkish U.S. Federal Reserve. And the European Central Bank will also come out with its September policy decision after raising interest rates for the first time in over a decade at their last meeting. ECB policymakers are expected to implement another bumper hike in a show of determination to tame soaring inflation. Now here's a look at the other stories we're tracking today. At this hour, the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee resumes its probe into the Education Department's procurement of allegedly overpriced laptops. The Senate panel is expected to release today its initial report also on the sugar importation mess after concluding investigations this week. Sherry Ann Torres will bring us the latest developments from there. Meanwhile, House lawmakers will continue their own probe on the sugar importation fiasco. Lady Vicentia will be covering that hearing. And House lawmakers will also continue their 2023 budget deliberations. On the agenda, the budgets of the Departments of Housing, Trade, Labor, and Migrant Workers.